Lynn Charles, and I'm here with my students for the second part of the first episode of 4 Point. I would like my students to introduce themselves to you.
Hi, my name is Christina.
Hello, my name is Dwi.
Hello, my name is Sarah.
And I'm Lara.
My name is Christina.
My name is Dwi.
My name is Sarah.
And my name is Lara.
We're very international, so German,
Chinese,
German,
and Italian.
Okay. And we are here at the Folkwang University in the Contemporary Dance Department, or the Zeitgenössische Tanzabteilung. These lovely ladies are studying to be contemporary dancers, but they chose as an elective, or in German it's called Wahlpflicht, they chose to do point. And we have been working together this winter semester and having a wonderful time and exploring and discovering and talking, and we would like to share this with you. So we will do the first three exercises that you saw with Bridget Zaire as a group, and then we will continue on with some other exercises. I hope you will enjoy it, and let's get to work. All right, we're going to start with the first exercise, which is arms crossed, chest open, wings in, lengthen the back of the neck, long legs, demi, knees and heels together, three quarter, demi, and stretch, demi, all the way over, yes, and going back through the shoe, and stretch. We do that twice in six and twice in eight. Yes? Then we continue on to the second part, which is demi, all the way over, stretch up, lengthen the toes, yes, and go back through, yes, twice in six, then twice in first, all the way over, stretch, 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 long toes, long legs, calves turned up, and roll down, then we go back to six, and we go the other way, up, we go all the way over, we stretch the instep, knees together, heels together, and we go back to the shoe, keep the heels together, and straight, and we do the same thing in first, yes? Demi, relevi, demi, Three times in first, long, 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 long stretch. Three in second, tandi to fifth. Three in fifth, tandi back to first. All right? Because we want to get into the center today, we only need to do it once. So we'll do it in first, in second, in fifth right front, and tandi, and in fifth left front. All right? That way we can make the bar slightly shorter today so we can do some fun stuff in the center. All right? Combine the first two exercises. Now we have our quick one. Yes. And a up, and a two, and a three, and a what? Da da dee, da 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 dee. Slide second, and a two, the three, stay, stay, and a yup, up, 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 up. Okay. Now remember, before we worked slow flexibility. Control. Now what are we aiming for? Pop. Quick releves. Without knee, still rolling, but quick up using our ankle and this part of the toe. Okay? And are we good for this?
Really
show me how to really use it in a good way. Not using the big one, also using the inner muscles, which is really focusing also on point. You always use the inner muscles of the leg. And also my upper body got really, really open. Somehow also this position of the bar doesn't allow you to really push on the bar. So you really use just the legs with really relaxing somehow the upper body. So I also got very open in this part. Yeah.
So for me, point work was always kind of constant work in my dance life, and it always helped me to make longer my legs that are especially problematic for these big muscles that my body have everywhere. So basically points help me to think about the tip of the toe until the end of the legs muscle that is actually the iliopsoas that finished here. So it makes you feel exactly this line traveling through the whole body and also until top of the head. And that's the most important thing. And also, as my colleague here, I have super weak ankles, and the point work makes you really work on it. That is not just the outside part of the ankles, but are all the muscles between and under your feet. It makes the feet really stronger and ready to grab the floor, because we are mostly working without any shoes. So the first part in contact with the floor, of course, is this part, this ball of the foot. So more we are able to grab it, to feel it, more we are sensible and active and ready for doing anything. And yes, I think that's a part of my point work.
But do you feel it has helped you for your contemporary dancing?
Yes, because it's anyway an object which we have to arrange our body. So it makes even difficult, and it makes even lighter when you don't have it, but you have the work behind you. So it's like, and super helpful.
What about you?
Yeah, for me, I can just maybe, I'm in the same opinion like my colleagues, but I can maybe just add that for me, it doesn't matter ballet or modern, you feel if you do point work or you don't do, because simply the muscle line is changing when you do it, and you're just more conscious about every step you do, if it's modern, if it's ballet, even improvisation, you feel that something.
You're more aware.
Exactly, yes. That is what my experience with point changed.
And I just think that one never knows. You might get in a company, and one piece, a choreographer might say, who can dance on point? And you can say, me. You just never know when it comes in handy. But I also agree, I think it develops all the muscles. And what you were saying about energy, I think the energy starts there, goes out to the end of your fingers, goes out up your neck and out your head. And I think that if the point work helps you for this, then it's accomplished.
And point work doesn't make you less contemporary.
No.
So
no.
It's not just a matter of work and how do you want to train.
Yeah.
It makes better balance. It makes you feel better the axe where to move your weight, because you have less base, which you have to adjust all your body. So it's really a 360 degrees work around it. Doesn't mean that you are a ballerina if you are doing point work.
No, not at all. Not at all. And I think it's been really interesting, our work. I've enjoyed watching your progress. I've also enjoyed watching your confidence develop. You were so shy in the beginning. And you're quite courageous now. No, I like that. I like that because it means you feel confident with what you're doing. And that's good. I mean, you want to be a dancer, so you need to know what you're doing. And so I think that has also helped. I feel that you've become more confident. And look, you want to get off the bar and move in the center. So that for me is